So we're coming off of a hell of an event. UFC 231. Live at the Scotiabank Event Center, Scotiabank Arena, formerly known as the Air Canada Center in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. One of my favorite cities on planet Earth. The New York City of Canada, as I like to call it. And Toronto has always been a good spot. I've never had a bad experience traveling to Toronto. It's always been fun. It's always been memorable going there for Blue Jays games or a Leafs game, which I've never actually been to, but I've always wanted to. And last but not least, going to a UFC event. I desperately really wanted to go to this event. This was one that I had circled on my calendar for months upon months upon months, but I just couldn't get out there, couldn't make it. Getting back traveling, I really didn't want to do more traveling. I went to North Carolina and I came back home, and the last thing I wanted to do was hit the road again and travel. So I watched the pay-per-view at the local brewery, local pub, whatever you want to call it. And I had a lot of preconceived notions heading into this fight with Max Holloway and Brian Ortega, the main event of the night of UFC 231, of this past Saturday's fight action live on pay-per-view. And that was that I thought Max Holloway was in for it against Brian Ortega. I thought that this would be his toughest challenge to date. That didn't mean I thought Max Holloway would lose, but I thought Brian Ortega was a very tough challenger, was a real threat to his title, undefeated, finished a lot of his opponents, fought Mike Conno very, very well, fought Frankie Edgar and finished him in devastating fashion. I thought Brian Ortega was a real challenger for Max Holloway. And I'm not going to take anything away from Brian Ortega with the performance that we know he had. Brian Ortega took a lot of punches, took a lot of tough shots, had to really go through hell in that fight with Max Holloway. So in that regard, he was one hell of a challenger. He showed true grit, true heart, true determination that would make any casual fan of MMA think, wow, I really respect this guy. This dude is a warrior of a fighter. And that was my biggest takeaway with Brian Ortega. But my biggest takeaway with Max Holloway was, holy moly, Max Holloway really did destroy Brian Ortega. That was not even a close fight. Really, the only round that I can, you know, lean towards Ortega and give him that round would be the third round, which I thought he fought brilliantly. He really showed that he had true grit, true heart, true determination, as I just stated, winning many of exchanges in that third round, which was just insane, given the fact that he had been outpunched, outworked, outmaneuvered in the first and second round. But there in the fourth round, Ortega, Holloway swapping punches. It was really rare to see Brian Ortega throw more than one punch in that round, and it wasn't rare to see Max Holloway land four, five, six punches at a time. The punches really, really piled up, so much so that statistically, Max Holloway broke the record for most strikes landed in a UFC bout, and it was a title fight. So to think that Max Holloway was this dominant as a champion in a fight that, as I said, I'm a hardcore fan of this sport. I've covered this sport for 4 years. I really believe that Brian Ortega was going to be a real stiff challenge for Max Holloway. And to see that fight play out the way that it did, with Max Holloway being a truly dominant force, shades of BJ Penn, shout out to Hawaii and their other favorite son, BJ Penn. Max Holloway is the definite favorite son of Hawaii now, carrying the torch for Hawaii, fighting just tooth and nail, bad to the bone fighting style, where he's just willing to swap punches with anyone and dares you to strike with him. And Ortega was dared, and he did not pass the test. He did not. He took the test. He didn't pass it. So what's next for Max Holloway? Really, I personally would like to see him at 155. I feel like there's a lot of good matchups for him out there. I feel like Conor McGregor, that fight is really the end game, pun intended, Avengers end game, pun intended, for the UFC. They really want to see that McGregor-Holloway fight. The first one was a dominant performance by Conor, but they're fighters that have really paved their own way, respectively. They've gone their own separate roads. They've done their own things that have been truly remarkable that history will look back on and say that both of these guys were great in their own right. But we got to see them fight again. We got to see Conor McGregor and Max Holloway fight again. Now, I don't know if that fight will happen next. I think it's a fight that is in the end game of the UFC. Fight that I do see happening, though, is maybe another title defense for Max Holloway. Maybe he does take on Frankie Edgar. I would hate to see that fight because I feel like Frankie Edgar really doesn't have anything to prove anymore. I don't think he should retire, but at the same time, fighting a man that's much bigger than him and Max Holloway, and knowing what he did to Ortega and what Ortega did to Frankie Edgar, it definitely causes me to have some concerns. And plus, I think Max Holloway, really, the health problems that he endured really were based off of the struggles that he had had losing weight, you know, cutting weight at 145. And now that he won't have to do that, then I definitely feel as if 155 would definitely suit him better. Plus, there's better matchups, more money. Really, the question is, does he fight Poirier, Ferguson? Does he fight Conor McGregor right out of the gate? Does he get that title shot against Habib if Conor wants to take a little break? Who knows? What I do know is I would like to see him fight at 155. I feel like that's the right fight. That's the right career move. I feel like he doesn't really have much to prove at 145. Plus, there's not really many money-making matchups for Holloway out there at 145. The division's kind of died down. Who does he fight? Mendez? Maybe, but that's a little bit of a stretch, being that Mendez was out of the game for a couple years. But Holloway, in his own right, a great fighter, great champion, somebody that I think the fans can really look at and say that this guy represents himself and the sport the right way, represents his state of Hawaii, his community, all of that. He represents himself very, very well. Very nice gentleman, you know, fighter, and somebody that I hope to see with a belt around his waist for quite a long time. I feel like he's that guy that really could do really well, really big things as far as furthering the growth of the sport with how he acts and how he portrays himself. I really appreciate that. As far as Brian Ortega, obviously he's got to take some time off. Maybe him fighting in one of the cards that's, you know, maybe International Fight Week or something like that will be a good return for him, but I expect him to be out for quite a while. He suffered a laundry list of injuries in this fight. Really, the main dynamic of the fight that I feel like Ortega missed out on is if he would have clinched Holloway early while they were dry, while the fight had just really started. I felt like the chance for a submission was there, but Ortega just didn't take it. I'm Ryan Thomas. That was my reaction to Max Holloway versus Brian Ortega. Max Holloway, and still the UFC featherweight champion. Take care, everybody.